In a search to save my life, I ended up discovering helpful and beneficial herbs and medicine, not only for me, but for my loved ones. As a result of being an angel light worker, I share my knowledge with the world. The time and work going into this production is fully a gift of God to be able to get all the information and put it in a form that is understandable and priceless. There is much more than what is in this book about Yacon and video production. And it works with maca and Jerusalem artichokes and kama and maca. All of these herbs and food sources vital to the South American culture and civilizations past. Now is the time like never before, as the assault against God's creation is in full force. Soli Deo Gloria. Smallanthus sanctifolius, miracle herb and staple. When beginning any new food or herbs, begin in baby steps. Take very tiny amounts to make sure it suits you. Gradually increase as needed. Consult your naturopath and other care providers and research on your own. The more you know, the better off you are.
Thank you.
With disease skyrocketing and discomforts among humanity, it's no surprise that Yacon has emerged, even though it's an ancient herb and food staple that's millions of years old. It was and has been known by many people other than the Americanas, and especially the South American people. And in, yet, it's almost a hidden item. And anything that is beautiful and organic that can heal and be such a wonderful aid to humanity and all God's creation is a beautiful thing. Yacon reduces cell proliferation associated with tumor growth and disease, especially carcinogens. Yacon improves immune system. The most magical wonder of this divine food and herb are these two properties, perhaps, because together the dance of life can continue, where in other conditions, without these health benefits and without other pharma aids, life may otherwise have shut down systems that fail. Systems that otherwise may fail on the basis of allergic shock and death. The concept of healthy body, healthy immune system gives the body a chance to thrive when it would otherwise shut down in oftentimes a very rogue genocide, perpetrating genocide through food, alimentarius codex, and general food and pharma guidelines, which allow for millions upon millions of people to die from allergic reactions and toxins in drugs and food and other items, and bad practices of bad leadership in the FDA and UN and State Department and other factors and corporations. Anyone who is complicit or complacent is guilty of this crime against humanity, and crime against God Himself, and crime against Mother Nature, which is a body and entity, which are bodies and entities. Depopulation, which as of 2017 April is in the process of being defunded, depopulation of the State Department of the United States of America is an actual department. It's called the Department of Depopulation. And it over a million deaths alone in 1 year reported by the FDA, but the actual figures are undoubtedly twice or three times that number easily. A country such as the USA, which puts down through death and euthanasia almost 10 million cats and dogs annually, likely more than that for years and years and years, numbers likely to increase as populations of animals are killed in Earth's worst genocide to date. We aren't talking here about abortions and the millions of babies every year that are genocided through that mechanism either. Together with the body works in additional ways, incorporating the health benefits of maca, especially red maca, also known as Peruvian ginseng. Another miracle worker and an adaptogen. Research reveals that cells are mini brains inside and outside bodies. The cellular membrane is a brain and the biggest brain of all. When the tallies of individual cells are added up all together, there is simply no way to get around it. It is also an organ, the largest organ in the human body. No longer is skin the largest organ. It is the cells that are the largest body and organ. In the background of this very slide are numerous, should I say nearly countless, forms of genocide displayed in plain sight by the very corporations and depopulation department, corporations and any entity such as the New World Order, the United Nations, any and all complicit rogue militaries, competing governments using deadly weapons against all of God's creation. Medicinal uses of Yacon. Yacon roots effectively works as dietary supplements and prevent and treat chronic diseases, including diabetes. It's a diet food for weight loss, weight maintenance. Yacon fights fat. Nutrition reduces cholesterol. Yacon reduces triglycerides. Yacon increases good cholesterol, HDL. Yacon decreases bad cholesterol, LDL. Yacon improves digestive health, especially colitis. Yacon's probiotic balances the flora and fauna in the abdominal and abdominal tract intestines. It fights IBS. Yacon is a prebiotic. Yacon is an antimicrobial. Yacon promotes regular bowel movements. Yacon regulates blood sugar. Yacon lowers blood pressure. Yacon is an anti-hyperglycemic by lowering glucose production, causing a shift to lower fasting glucose rates. Yacon strengthens the immune system. Yacon is an adaptogen like maca. Yacon helps body absorb vitamins and nutrients from other foods in the body. Thank you. Yacon helps the pancreas by aiding the liver and its health because it regulates and balances sugars. Because regulated, balanced sugars lighten the load of the pancreas and its production of insulin needed for good health. Yacon is an antioxidant. Yacon is an appetite depressant. I should say an appetite suppressant. Yacon is a hepatic. Yacon is a hypoglycemic. Yacon is a laxative. Helps with weight loss. Yacon reduces DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid damage, which is reducing genetic damages from toxins in the environment and in foods and everything else. Yacon reduces cell proliferation associated with tumor growth and disease, especially carcinogenesis, which is cancer-causing diseases. Yacon improves the immune system. Yacon is a prebiotic and a probiotic and a polyphenol catabolite of epinephrine, metanephrine, which is an inactive metabolite of chlorogenic acids, a phytochemical and antioxidant and tumor inhibitor. Yacon is a caffeic acid natural fungicide. Caffeic acid, which is unrelated to caffeine, is biosynthesized by hydroxylation of coumaryl ester of quinic acid, esterified through a side chain alcohol. This hydroxylation produces the caffeic acid ester of shikimic acid, which converts to chlorogenic acid. It is the precursor to ferulic acid, coniferol alcohol, and cinephil alcohol, all of which are significant building blocks in lignin. The transformation to ferulic acid is catalyzed by the enzyme caffeate O-methyltransferase. Lignin is a class of complex organic polymers that form important structural materials in the support tissues of vascular plants and some algae. Lignins are particularly important in the formation of cell walls, especially in wood and bark, because they lend rigidity and do not rot easily. Chemically, lignins are cross-linked phenolic polymers, ferulic acids, metabolite. So what does that have to do with people? Well, yacon can strengthen the cell walls, which give a defense against toxins and carcinogens, including carcinogens. Yacon, more medical. Pancreatic cells and glycogen-like peptide 1, GLP-1, increased. Visceral abdominal fat is reduced with Yacon, and fasting insulin serum levels were raised slightly in diabetics. Yacon helps to decrease serum glucose levels. Praise God. Yacon has beneficial health effects for obese, premenopausal women. With insulin resistance, it helps with sperm health, and a mixture of extracts from Peruvian plants, black maca, and yacon improves sperm count and reduce glycemia. Yacon benefits women in all stages of PMS, perimenopause, menopause, postmenopause, and their menstrual cycle and premenstrual cycles. And it helps men as well in hormone balances. Yacon plant parts used. Roots and leaves, rhizomes, mostly the root tubers attached to the rhizomes. Yacon plants treated with love, sustainably grown with organic non-toxic soil and fertilizer is best, giving the plant time to grow without toxic chemicals, allowing the yacon to grow for a few years, then allowing the soil to rejuvenate over a period of time before resuming planting and harvesting. This gives Mother Nature time to be at rest before going to work hard again. In the biblical times, the land was allowed to go fallow, so nothing was grown. About every 7 years, the land had time to rejuvenate in that 1 year. Yacon has been food and staple for over 25,000 years. I say millions of years. Yields of one yacon tuber can reach about 3 pounds. As the green rhizomes die back from freeze or drought, especially freezing, the tubers are ready to harvest. Yacon is a healthy replacement for sugar. Yacon's constituents. Yacon protocaturic. Chlorogenic, caffeic, and ferulic acids, FOS, fructooligosaccharide is FOS, and an indigestible form of fructose and insulin. Yacon is mostly made of water and sugar, FOS, which is the fructooligosaccharides. FOS, fructooligosaccharide, is an indigestible form of fructose. FOS, fructooligosaccharide. Fermentation occurs only in the large intestine, and because of this feature and the fact that it does not break down in the abdomen means that most of the sugar calories are not absorbed. Most of Yacon's sugars are not absorbed into the system, thus weight gain is at a minimal from this FOS source. FOS fermentation in the large intestine has a bifidogenic effect, producing H1CO2 lactate, short chain fatty acids, SCFAs. pH reduction in the large intestine gut microbiota modulation occurs with Yacon. With Yacon, mineral absorption by bones happens. With Yacon, there's immunomodulation, anti-carcinogenic and pathogen inhibitor, and lipid metabolism. With Yacon, interaction of intestinal microbiota, intestinal epithelium, and the host's innate immune system is associated with most diseases, including colitis and carcinogenin, CRC. There are between 500 and 1,000 different bacterial species with a total weight of 1.5 kilograms in the large intestine at any given time. And 1 pound equals 2.54 kilograms. So think about that. FOS. Fructooligosaccharides. Consumption increases short-chain fatty acids, SCFA production. SCFA acetate. SCFA propionate. SCFA butyrate. SCFA reduce inflammation. SCFA reduce cancer. SCFA work by increasing local immune response. SCFA works by decreasing colon pH. La la! SCFA promotes ammonia excretion. SCFA promotes amine excretion. Fructooligosaccharides, FOS, can selectively modulate and regulate the composition and function of intestinal microbiota. FOS promotes the growth of bifidobacteria of a genus gram-positive pleomorphic rods that play a regulatory role in the colon by inhibiting the growth of putrefactive bacteria. Bifidobacteria decrease the expression of xenobiotic metabolizing enzymes and stimulate the immune system in the colon, in the colony mucosa. Fructooligosaccharides, FOS, leads to increased SCFA, which suppress and resist and fight inflammation and cancer by increasing local immune response, decreasing colon pH, and promoting ammonia and amine excretion, and inducing apoptosis. Apoptosis is the process of programmed cell death that occurs in multicellular organisms. Biochemical events lead to characteristic cell changes, i.e. morphology and death. And this is what the GMO foods and products have been programmed to do to humans and God's creation. FOS has ability to indirectly influence immune activity through SCFA production that modulates the intestinal microbiota composition. SCFA promote a state of immune tolerance and modulate interleukin IL production and natural killer NK cell activity. FOS, fructooligosaccharides, directly modulates the immune system through the gut-associated lymphoid tissue, GALT, and some believe it is not through the gut microbiota, but I believe it as well. FOS, fructooligosaccharides, natural compounds, fructose and polysaccharides, can activate specialized immune cells, macrophages, dendritic cells, lymphocytes, and neutrophils through mimicking pathogen-associated molecular patterns, PAMPs, that bind to toll-like receptors, TLR, causing immune modulatory effects. TLR-mediated activation of NK natural killer cells can promote IFNY production and increase anti-tumor cytotoxicity. Direct and indirect immunomodulation mechanisms can synergistically, the creation of a whole that is greater than the simple sum of its parts, induce robust regulatory cellular immune responses. Yacon does even more. It is able to help maintain colonic homeostasis without inducing inflammatory responses, reinforcing the intestinal barrier against pathogens, and improving anti-tumor defense. Yacon chemistry. The leaves of the yacon contain quantities of protocatechic, chlorogenic, caffeic, and ferulic acids do not affect the adrenals like caffeine. Yacon, yacon root, botanical name, Smallanthus sanctifolius aspirata. Yacon is a food crop cultivated in the North Andes, and high in the Amazon mountains, leading down into the Amazon Valley. The leaves, rhizome, and tubers attached growing on the rhizomes are all edible. Yacon does not grow at elevations as high as maca. The tubers have a carbohydrate called fructooligosaccharides, FOS, which has a low glycemic index and caloric value. Yacon, FOS, are a prebiotic soluble fiber fermented in the large intestine colon by beneficial bacteria including Bifidus and Lactobacillus. Yacon root and yacon root syrup are a great sweetener for those who need to improve overall health and especially to lower blood sugar and losing weight. And yacon is especially useful for building the body up against allergens and resisting the allergens that are oftentimes from GMO sources intended to injure and destroy and kill people through genocide. Part of the depopulation mechanisms. Yacon preparation methods and dosage. Yacon root syrup is extracted from the fresh root and is available commercially, but it is extremely expensive. A better bet is to use yacon root powder to add sweetness to baked goods, smoothies, and sprinkled on foods. You also avoid any adulteration with added fructose by used bulk root powder. A tea is made also from the fresh leaves in South America. And fresh slices of yacon root are also eaten raw. Yacon roots. Roots can be eaten raw, and their sweet, crunchy texture give liken to an apple. The main stem is also edible and is cooked as a vegetable in South America cooking. Yacon grows from Venezuela to Argentina at high altitudes and is in the same plant family as sunflower. Stem and leaves. Nutritional content of yacon is high in potassium, iron, copper, calcium, manganese, zinc, phosphorus. Tubers of yacon contain all of the nutrients that the stem and leaves contain above, and additionally, tubers contain retinol and vitamin A. As well as thiamine, ascorbate, carotene, riboflavin, niacin, thiamine sucrose, fructose, glucose, phenolics, tryptophan, chorogenic acid, insulin. The tubers contain fructooligosaccharide, an indigestible polysaccharide made up of fructose. Fructooligosaccharides taste sweet, but pass through the human digestive tract unmetabolized, hence have very little caloric value. Moreover, fructooligosaccharides have a prebiotic effect, meaning they are used by beneficial bacteria that enhance colon health and aid digestion. Yacon plants can grow to over 2 meters in height and produce small, inconspicuous yellow flowers at the end of the growing season. Traditionally, yacon roots are grown by farmers at mid-elevations of the eastern slopes of the Andes and descending towards the Amazon. Tubers with growing points can be planted in a garden bed in early spring near the time of the last frost and new moon. While aerial parts are damaged by frost, the tubers are not harmed unless they freeze solid. Yacon is a propagating plant growing like Jerusalem artichokes. The plants grow best with organic fertilizer. After the first couple of frosts, the tops will die off and the tuberous roots are ready for digging up. It is generally best to leave some tubers in the ground for propagating the following spring, or kept in cool or buried away from frost until spring. Yacon, while usable sized tubers develop fairly early in the season, they taste much sweeter after they mature and are exposed to the cold and frost. Yacon medicinal uses. Yacon roots effectively work as dietary supplements and prevent and treat chronic diseases, diabetes, diet food for weight loss, weight management, fights fat, reduces cholesterol, reduces triglycerides, increases good cholesterol, HDL, decreases bad cholesterol, LDL, improves digestive health, especially colitis. Inside yacon is a miracle herb and food from God that Mother Nature has in her garden for people of Peru and throughout South America. As the world faces greater adversity through global genocide in the depopulation stages, another great world civilization faces doom, and now the people of South America hold a vital role in the salvation of God's creation. The same people and region of the earth where more plants and trees grow than any other place on earth face ruin as selective elite corporate banksters and others destroy the land for toxic crops, harness the rivers, making catastrophic dams, destroying forests, cities, indigenous zones, animals, medicine plants, systems of nature, people, and Mother Nature herself, not just for greed and because they are mean and inconsiderate, but because they can. They use an endless payroll, bank drafts, money with zero gold to back up their transactions, and get away with global murder of God's creation, and they must stop this genocide once and for all. Soli Deo Gloria, forever.
Thank you.